same spirit as any other children. We would find out eventually. But Lucius felt like he was finally in the driver's seat for the throne. The prophecy was still unfulfilled, but the evil was felling. As was the boy. Nearby buses were the best way to meet Lucius.
Such prodigious results. I am thoroughly impressed with you.
As Lucius took the scroll, he felt a warm feeling inside of him. Something that might have been lost for a while, but was there again. The sound of the seventh trumpet signaled the third wall. This was the final trumpet sound, and the final wall. Loud voice of an eagle in heaven proclaims the Antichrist as a new ruler forever. The rest of mankind who were not killed by these plagues still did not repent the work of their hands. They did not stop worshiping their puny god. The boy sneaked into a bus that was evacuating the town. None of the passengers suspected anything. While sitting on the back seat, he looked down at the scroll he held in his hand. It was sealed with seven seals. These seals were not to be opened by hand, but by actions that would lead to them melting away. He had put him through many tests, but now I was sure. Lucius was worthy of his kindness. I would continue to guide him throughout the journey, but let him take his own wicked steps. I was to look after him when he didn't suspect it, and I would be there when he most needed it. The prophecy was not yet over, but just begun. Next, he would have to open the seven seals.
I have many sons, and I will have many more, but this one is special. This one continues to surprise me with his crafty ways of delivering my wrath. His creativity is definitely without comparison, and he will be more than ready to take us towards rapture. It will be 1,000 years of darkness as I take my place with the mortals. They will learn to take judgment seriously, and Lucius will be there with me. My son, the Dark Prince, the little Antichrist.
Oops. Triple kill.
Excellent.